Hello, in this class of ours we are going to study what is electrolytic decomposition. We have already studied photodecomposition and thermal decomposition. So electrolytic decomposition means decomposition of a substance or splitting up of a substance into its constituents on a passage of electricity through it. First example that we will see here is of water. It is water. When made to pass electricity through itself, divides into hydrogen and oxygen. If you take pure water, see, pure water does not conduct electricity. So either you need to add some salt so that ions that can decompose into ions, and once through liquids it are ions which conduct electricity. So here we have taken acidified water, water with some acid added into it. So that will that acid, when dissolved into water, dissociates into ions, and these ions are the ones that will carry electricity through water. This is a battery, positive, negative terminal, positive terminal. Here negative terminal has been connected to one of the electrodes, that is called cathode. Another one is called anode. This is positive electrode is called anode. Now inverted tubes we have kept. This is filled with water. The arrangement you can see, and how it happens is when water, see, hydrogen is positive case and oxygen is negative. So negative one will be drawn by the positive electrode, oxygen will go and get collected over anode. This is one most frequently asked question, that over which electrode which gas will collect it. Hydrogen is undoubtedly positive, will go to the negative electrode which is called cathode. This is negative, that will go on to the positive electrode which is called anode. That is one question answered. Another thing is, when this breaks down, then the volume of this gas, see, in this tube which is containing hydrogen, water is filled only up to here, whereas in this tube which contains oxygen, water is filled up to here, gas is up to here, and gas is up to here in this. So this itself shows that the volume of hydrogen is twice than the volume of oxygen. So the obvious question will come to you is why. So that is, when one molecule of water, H2O, one molecule of water contains two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. So the volume of hydrogen in a molecule of water is double than what it is that of oxygen. So this is how we can identify, and or we can have explained, which gas will have the volume double, hydrogen or oxygen. Hydrogen will definitely have, on its decomposition into hydrogen and oxygen, one molecule of water supplies two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen. So hydrogen by volume is double in water than oxygen. There is another question. The last question will be, both these gases are colorless and both are odorless. So how to identify? Once these tubes are filled with the gases, you can take a burning splinter near to the mouth of a tube without knowing which gas is contained into this tube. And if that gas in that tube starts burning with a pop sound, that gas starts burning with a pop sound. Pop sound means little explosion. That undoubtedly is hydrogen, because the hydrogen itself burns. And when you take the splinter near to the mouth of a tube, whereby if you carry your splinter, the brightness with which the splinter was glowing will increase, because oxygen supports combustion. So this is how we will identify which tube contains hydrogen and which tube contains oxygen. So I believe that was all about pure water cannot conduct electricity. You need to acidify, that will dissociate into ions. Ions will conduct electricity, that will divide water into hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen is positive, that will go on to cathode. Oxygen is negative, will go on to the anode, and volume of hydrogen will be double than that of oxygen, and identification is done. I believe that is more than sufficient at this point of time. Now we will go on to two more substances which can be whose electrolytic decomposition is possible. Let us, one is NaCl and another is Al2O3. This is aluminum oxide, this is sodium chloride. See, both these ones you need to take in molten state. Also, if they are dissolved into water, they dissociate into ions and they conduct electricity. And also, when they are taken into molten state, they conduct electricity, because then also they dissociate into ions. But if you take their aqueous solution and then pass electricity, so rather than getting metal, you will get metal hydroxide. So for us at this point of junction,
junction, it is enough to know, at this point it is enough for us to know that they are to be taken in molten state, melt them and then pass electricity through them. So that this reaction will take place is Na and Cl. This will be Cl2, so 2Na, 2NaCl. Al2O3, this will turn into Al plus O2. Here 3, 2, so 3, 3 to the 6, 3, 2, 4 Al. This is how, see, this metal is obtained always at cathode. Also, this metal will be always, of any metal can be obtained only at cathode during the electrolysis. And the reason being, because they form electropositive ions. Metals form electropositive ions. Those electropositive ions can be attracted by the cathode alone. Because they are positive, cathode is negative, a force of attraction develops and they go onto the cathode. But you need to take them in molten state. This is the reaction, how the dissociation or the decomposition of aluminium oxide and sodium chloride will take place. So with this, our this class is over.